This election season, voters in South Florida are focused on slime balls. Thick green algae like this has been menacing waterfront communities for months. Warmer weather and runoff of man-made nutrients like fertilizer acts as steroids, boosting the natural bacteria into monsters like this.
It's all the way to Cape Coral and it's making its way out past Shell Point.
Scaring away home buyers and tourists alike. Constituents say it's time to drain the swamp fast.
I've never been into politics and now I'm all over it.
Charter boat captain Nick Fisher says his business is suffering. He took us into this gooey Cape Coral Canal to show us what's motivated him to vote for the first time in his life.
Have you ever seen conditions this bad?
No, this is horrible. I've never wanted to vote or anything my entire life. This year I registered to vote specifically to vote for a candidate that's going to help benefit Florida.
While a deadly red tide bacteria is decimating sea life off the Florida coast, this separate blue-green algae is impacting the state's freshwater systems inland. It's a rare 1-2 punch for those that rely on clean waterways to survive.
When you get up close to this stuff, it's disgusting. It's smelly, and you can only imagine what the wildlife is going through that lives in it and near it.
The bacteria accumulates in Lake Okeechobee. When water levels rise, billions of gallons are released. But natural flow south through the Everglades and sugar farms is mostly blocked. Instead, bacteria-laden water is redirected east and west. Many impacted residents lay blame on a political system that prioritizes profitable agriculture business in exchange for campaign funding.
Clean the water out!
Captain Chris Whitman is the co-founder of Captains for Clean Water.
Smell it.
A nonprofit working to restore the Everglades and preserve Florida's natural habitats.
Unfortunately, our water management system decades ago was manipulated. But ultimately, this does come back on our representatives. It's their responsibility to manage our water systems for the good of the people and for the good of the entire system. And right now, they're not doing that.
So do you feel like we're now at a breaking point?
I think we are.
That breaking point may be soon for business owners like Rob Smith.
Captain Rob's Bait and Tackle.
He says sales at his bait and tackle shop are down some 70%.
Platforms and stuff are made to win elections. You don't know if they're actually going to follow through with anything. So a lot more people are going to vote. They're trying to find out where the candidates are.
Cue the political slime slinging. In this race for the Senate, Republican Governor Rick Scott lobbed this ad at Democratic incumbent Senator Bill Nelson.
With Bill Nelson, we get more waiting, more talk, and more algae.
And Nelson slapped back, telling voters Rick Scott caused this problem. The message from voters? Figure it out now.